Like, this is okay.
This is the Tonight Show. You're Carson.
But we figured out a way.
You're Carson now. Do you know that, right? That's the difference. That's the shift. That's why Netflix can't even compete. Netflix is done.
They're not done.
Done.
What are you talking
done.
About?
You see Charlie Wilson's War?
No.
Movie about, Tom Hanks movie about America getting involved with the Afghan conflict.
I didn't see the Afghanistan War.
Doesn't really matter. But the idea is this. They're fighting the Russians, the Afghanis, right?
Right.
So the Americans go, okay, boom. Give them a $5,000 rocket launcher, and they're going to shoot down a $5 million helicopter. And eventually, Russia just won't be able to compete, right? Netflix pays $100 million to Aaron Sorkin or whoever to make a TV show.
Right.
Right? That distracts you for 2 hours.
Right.
YouTube pays $0 million to Joe Rogan and Jamie to make a podcast that distracts you for 2 hours every day. Netflix cannot compete.
But it's a different animal. You got to realize, first of all, they have way more people than just me. They also are putting together something that requires a lot of money to create.
Sure.
If you enjoy films,
yes,
if you enjoy a show like Ozark or Stranger Things,
long form narrative,
it takes a lot of money to make those things. There's special effects, there's camera people and makeup people and hair. There's a lot of lot going on. Writers and directors and producers and actors, and it's a giant fucking tent filled with people.
But people aren't watching it. You know what they're watching?
A lot of people are watching that.
They're watching Friends, bro.
No, they're watching Friends.
Dude, there's a reason they paid
Friends is terrible.
Bro, it doesn't matter if it's terrible. As Jamie, the two most viewed shows on Netflix right now, Netflix doesn't own. Okay? Netflix isn't even trying to make money anymore. They're getting bought out. It's Facebook,
Amazon. They're getting bought out by who?
That they want to. That's the goal, the strategy now. They're $10 billion in debt. There's no way they can make money.
They're $10 billion
in
debt?
$10 billion.
Really? But they make hundreds of millions of dollars a month. Like, how many people do they have on board? How many subscribers do they have that are paying $9?
As far as I know, they don't share that information.
They're killing it in terms of subscribers, but they're $10 billion in debt. They just talk on another $2 billion, right? When I say Netflix is done, I'm speaking... Anytime I make declarations, I'm speaking in the future, right? I'm like, we prepare now for the future, right? So it's like...
Well, how are they... Here it goes. Netflix will keep Friends through next year in a $100 million
agreement. They're paying $100 million, right? For 1 year of Friends, and then The Office, too.
You know what that is, though? That's like nostalgia.
Nostalgia, right?
Yeah.
So all viewing right now is nostalgia.
No, not all viewing.
Bro, if you look at TV, right? What did great this past year's in TV, right? The OJ trial on FX. What is that? I remember I was when the OJ thing came out.
Did that do that great?
Killed it.
Really?
Won all the awards, everything. The Versace story, which is another thing.
Am I that out of the loop?
I'm just...
$139 million subscribers paying $10 a month. Is that what it is? How much does it cost?
Something like that. Maybe even more. Maybe 11.
How much does it cost?
They just bumped it up to 12, I think.
$12 a month.
Sure.
That, ladies and gentlemen, is a fuckload of income.
Sure.
So they got a lot coming in, but they're spending a lot too because they're trying to overtake all the others. And then they got Jeff Bezos, you know, Captain Moneybags up there. Scrooge McDuck is trying to do the same thing.
Facebook should buy
which
it.
Is where I saw you on Sneaky Pete. Yeah. I was like, Andrew.
But that's the thing. Bezos can lose money on this shit because he's making tons of money on paper towels.
I wonder how much he is losing because he's got a lot of fucking series that ain't nobody watching on that.
Just put it out there.
But he's doing something that's even more weird.
Okay.
Because there's no one watching those shows.
Yeah.
There's a ton of fucking shows on Amazon that fucking no one's watching.
Yeah.
I would like to see their numbers because I bet they have some shows that they might have spent $1 million to make and have like 4 viewers.
Yeah.
There's fucking no one watching these shows.
They were just going after awards. Their thing was, we're going to make the artsiest shit. Hollywood's going to give us a Grammy or something like that, and then it will qualify our platform. It's a smart approach. Like, YouTube's approach was the exact opposite, right? We're like, we're just going to create the stuff that we think people want to watch.
Well, YouTube doesn't create much.
They did a little, and they took down the paywall. Like, my thing, my guess with YouTube is they're waiting for Netflix. You know that scene in the movie where, that somebody's caught in, a enclosed space and water starts coming in and the water gets right up to his lips, you know, he's trying to breathe a little bit more, and I think YouTube just is going to be the one to pour the last drop of water.
Well, I think it's such a different thing. I think you're talking about two totally different things, because Netflix has never aimed to be a user created content streaming site.
Right They're not, but at the end of the day, it's just distraction. I think that's what we got to start looking at content as, right? It's just raw distraction. And Netflix occupies a space for distraction that's smaller than YouTube. So I can watch a 2-hour thing on YouTube at home on my TV.
Mm-hmm.
I can watch 2 minute thing on the bus as I'm going to work on YouTube. You know, I can watch a 15 minute, you know, piece like vlog or something like that. I can watch all the whole spectrum. Netflix, I'm really just watching at home or like if I'm on a trip. You know what I mean? It's really, I'm not watching a 2 minute thing on Netflix.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It is the shit for now. Don't get me wrong. It's absolutely the shit for now. Right. But if I'm putting my money on it, I would say if I'm Facebook, I buy it. And then imagine having your Facebook feed. You just watch the show and then you get to share it immediately on your Facebook
feed. If I was Facebook, I'd be super careful about buying anything because I think the government's been thinking about breaking them up for a while.
Oh,
and
really?
Elizabeth Warren is already talking about that. That's one of the parts of her platform in running for president is breaking up Apple, breaking up Facebook, breaking up Twitter. She wants to break up all these things she thinks are monopolies.
What's your feeling on that?
Get the fuck out of here with that.
She is goofy, man.
She's goofy as fuck. What's up?
The Disney takeover of 21st Century Fox takes place, I think, next week, the 20th.
It's a big one. They're going to put out their own streaming
Everything.
Service.
They've bought like everything except for Fox News and Fox Sports.
Yeah.
Whoa. They
took over all of their production, movie facilities.
Hmm.
Like 5,000 people might be losing their job because
but
Disney
all that content's
them.
Coming off of Netflix, all those Marvel shows, all that shit is going to come over to them.
Really?
So now they're going to have a nice
competition. I wonder why that's why they've been canceling all these Marvel shows.
Absolutely.
On Netflix.
Why would I keep investing in something that you're going to take off? Like I'm going to build up a brand and then you're going to remove it?
Right. Own it.
So they got all the kids' movies. You're a dad. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Dude, I go to Disneyland twice a year at least.
But you're going to not have a streaming Disney program for your kids?
Apple's also starting their streaming service soon.
No right. Isn't it like exactly tomorrow
when.
Or some shit?
No one knows when, but there's a bunch of tons of rumors are coming out today.
The game, you know what it's like? You know the perestroika?
Mm-hmm.
Like what happened in Russia, like where the overnight, you know, it fell and they sold off the state assets to like a few people and everybody became billionaires?
Right.
Like, that's what's happening right now in entertainment, dude. People don't realize it, but like it's fucking done. Like the days of like fame being about distance are done.
Distance.
Like, I'm Johnny Depp. I'm going to go away to my like little home somewhere in the Alps and you will see me twice a year. You know, and I'm weird. Oh, Marlon Brando. I'm out here. I'm weird. I'm different. You know, it's like now it's proximity. There's a reason why.
No value in being weird anymore?
Bro.
Marlon Brando, Tyler Perry has an island.